Organisms with supernatural powers are always fascinating, but they are no more restricted to fiction stories. They are a part of a practical scientific world. Imagine a mice glowing in the dark, or a plant that fights its deadliest predator. These are not just thoughts, but successful experiments. Today, all thanks to biotechnology, we have several products with wide applications in the fields of agriculture, environment, healthcare, and many more. And what kind of products are we talking about? In this video, we will mainly be discussing about the transgenic organisms, also known as genetically modified organisms and abbreviated as GMOs. And what do we mean by transgenic or genetically modified organisms? An organism which contains DNA from another organism integrated into its genomic DNA is called transgenic organism. So will transgenic organisms be different from their original parental forms? Of course they will. A mice will not usually glow in the dark, but when we manipulate its genes, then the transgenic mice obtained shows the unusual ability to glow in the dark brightly. Let's get introduced to these examples individually. To begin with, we have the cotton plant named BT cotton. And what does this BT mean? Does it stand for biotechnology? No, the prefix BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis, the bacteria which comes to the rescue of cotton plants. Have you come across the phrase, "The enemy of my enemy is my friend"? Well, that's exactly the case we're going to look at. Cotton plants have the biggest enemies in the form of insects. And there are certain bacteria, like the Bacillus thuringiensis, which are like the enemies of these insects. They're actually capable of producing certain toxins that can kill these insects. Thus, for the cotton plant, their enemy's enemy, which is the bacterium, is like a friend. And this relation is exploited by genetic engineers to get cotton modified. Let's find out how. The first thing we need to know is about the protein and then about the gene which creates the magic. These bacteria produce certain proteins which are capable of killing various insects like cotton bollworms, beetles and others. These proteins are also called toxins. The genes encoding the toxins is called cryogene. And don't these toxins harm the bacterial cell? Nope. Inside the bacterial cells, these toxins are present in the form of crystals, which are inactive by nature. The crystals get activated only when in contact with the apt pH conditions found in the gut of the insects. Hence, the toxins are harmful only to the insects and not the bacterial cells. Now what we do is take the cryogene from the bacterium and insert it into the cotton plant through one of the various methods of gene transfer. And once inside the cotton plant, the gene gives rise to proteins which are present in inactive crystallized forms in the plant as well. These, when consumed by the insects, get activated inside their gut, creating holes in the lining and eventually killing the organism. This is how cotton plants get the ability to naturally fight the threats and get benefited. In this way, transgenic plants can be created using genetic engineering. Various other useful plants that have better resistance capacity or which have high yield can be designed using such techniques. Several important and beneficial traits can thus be incorporated in plants. And what about animals? Transgenic animals are also a boon to researchers. Let's learn about an interesting transgenic animal in the next video.